Hi, welcome. Today we are going to study fission yield, which is the fourth point from the topic nuclear fission. So first one is the cumulative chain fission yield. Now this term is used to describe mass distribution between the fragments. We know that when a nucleus, suppose for example uranium having atomic mass number 235 is bombarded with neutron, it get excited, and after excitation it undergo nuclear fission and there is a formation of primary fission fragments. So how mass is distributed between that fragments, it is explained with the help of cumulative chain fission yield. It is defined as very simple definition. YA is equal to number of product nuclei of mass number A divided by total number of nuclei fission into 100. So how many products are formed having mass number A divided by how many nuclei are fissioned. So when we multiply it with 100, we get that value in percentage. So this is about cumulative chain fission yield. Now we will see one simple example, fission fragment yield as a function of mass number in the fission of uranium 235 by neutrons. So this is the curve which shows mass number against fission yield. So these mass numbers are of the fission fragments. So when uranium 235 is bombarded with neutron, that uranium nucleus get excited. After excitation it shows fission and gives us primary fission fragments. Now that primary fission fragments, they are unstable. You know that they are having excess neutrons, therefore they undergo further beta minus emission to give us stable product, and that stable product, it is a isobaric with the primary fission fragment. So the beta minus emissions takes place until we get the stable product. Now consider this table, fission yield mass number A1 and mass number A2. So at this side fission yield is shown. Now if fission yield is greater than or equal to 1%, so it means that 10 raised to 0 in this plot, 10 raised to 0 means 1. So when that yield is greater than 1%, at that time mass number A1, so A1 represents mass number of lighter fragment. So the range of that mass number is 85 to 105. So if we look into that plot, so 85, so above 10 raised to 0, so 85 to 105. So this part is of a lighter fragment, mass number of lighter fragment, and this part of curve is mass number of a heavier fragment. So A2, it is having 130 to 150 mass number. See, above 10 raised to 0, 130 to 150. So this is for fission yield greater than or equal to 1%. Now if we consider yield which is greater than or equal to 7%, so something here. So for that A1 lighter fragment have mass number 90 to 100. So this part 90 to 100. At the same time heavier fragment have mass number 134 to 144. So this is true for the fission yield greater than or equal to 7%. Now at last see fission yield which is nearly equal to 0.05%, that is 10 raised to minus 2 into this plot. So it is observed that, this is the experimental observation, that lighter fragment have mass number 170. Similarly, heavier fragment also have mass number 117. So they have similar mass number. Fragment, lighter fragment as well as heavier fragment. So what are the observations from this plot? First observation is the majority of the fissions are asymmetric, that is A1 is not equal to A2. So see, this is greater than or equal to 1%, this is greater than or equal to 7%. In both cases there is a difference between mass number of lighter fragment and the heavier fragment. They are not symmetric. So majority of the fissions are asymmetric, that is A1 is not equal to A2. And the second observation is that the yield of symmetrical fission is lowest. So when we get 117 and 117, at that time fission yield is 0.05%. This is 0.05%. So the yield of symmetrical fission is lowest. So these two are the main observations of this plot. Now this is true for fission by thermal or low energy neutrons. So what observations we have said here, these observations are true for fission by thermal or low energy neutrons. This is not true for the high energy neutrons. If we increase the energy of the particle which affect fission, for example here in case of uranium-235 we have used neutron, we can also use deuteron. Okay, so if we increase the energy of that particle, the depth of the valley between the two peaks diminishes and the two peaks approach till there is a single peak of symmetric fission. So see what is happens here. So if we increase the energy of that particle which affect the nuclear fission, so this depth of the valley, this is the valley and it is deeper. So when we increase the energy, that depth of the valley between these two peak diminishes and the two peak approach till there is a single peak of symmetric fission. So we will see one example of also it. So this is example. In this fission fragment yield as a function of mass number in the fission of plutonium-239 by deuteron of varying energy. We are going to vary energy of the deuteron. See, again mass number versus fission yield. So initially it is deeper. At that time energy is 9.2 millielectron volt. Then it become 12.3. So when we increase the energy, the depth of valley start to diminish. When we go to 15.0, it becomes something as like this. When go from 16.1, it become as like this. So finally when we reach at 23.4, there is now no valley and we get a single peak of symmetric fission. So when we see example of this example uranium-235, at that time we have used neutron to bombard uranium-235, but there is no variation in energy. The low energy neutrons we have used, or it is true for the thermal neutrons, but when we increase the energy of that particle, it may be neutron or deuteron, so when we increase the energy of that particle, the depth of the valley between the two peak diminishes and the two peaks approach till there is a single peak of symmetric fission. So at a high energetic radiations, or when we apply particle of high energy, at that time we can get fragments having a same atomic mass number. So this is about the fission yield. I have taken some questions. First one is, what is cumulative chain fission yield? You have to write definition of it, simple question. Then explain fission fragment yield as a function of mass number in the fission of uranium-235 by neutrons, and another question is of plutonium-239. So this is all about fission yield. Thank you.